And welcome back. Our chef on a shoestring is Lachlan Patterson. He's got a hit restaurant, Frasca, in Boulder, Colorado, and it features local ingredients and a menu inspired by the rustic cooking of northwestern Italy. Now, this morning, an Easter menu for four people on our budget of just $40. Now, we brought you all the way out here from Boulder, Colorado, so I guess our $40 budget, we pretty much blown that.
Right, we do Colorado lamb.
So, what's on the menu for this morning?
So, we're going to do a Colorado leg of lamb roasted with radishes, arugula salad, and for dessert, a great dish called gubana.
Excellent. Looks good over there. All right. All right, let's start us off. So we get the leg of lamb here.
So we have the leg of lamb, and it's butterflied out. You can butterfly it yourself or ask your butcher to.
Best way to go, boneless, correct?
Boneless.
Okay.
Boneless. And this is about 2 pounds. So we're going to put a little bit of mustard. It's nothing like lamb and mustard.
Any special type of mustard? Or is
this is
just
Dijon.
Dijon?
Okay. Yeah, this is just standard Dijon. And we want to just spread it evenly throughout. Get a little bit. We're going to tie it afterwards, so you don't want to leave it all in the center. And then this is rosemary.
Okay.
We're going to sprinkle with a little bit of rosemary.
Chopped up nicely.
Chopped up nice. A little bit of garlic, which
not
is nice.
Much.
Not too much, just a little bit. When it cooks, though, all the juices will mix together. Okay, so then we kind of put it together like this.
Okay.
We have some butcher's twine here. And we'll lay two pieces of butcher's twine.
Is this normal? I mean, this would the way you'd want to do it to kind of wrap it up like this?
Exactly.
Throw the twine around it. You need some help with that? Are you okay?
Yeah, please. Yeah, so you hold the twine.
Okay.
And you want to do that, otherwise it'll dry out in the center. If you left the mustard on its own, it would just become dry.
So nice and snug. The oven is preheated to what temperature behind us?
The oven's preheated to 375.
375, and we're anticipating to cook this for how long?
This will take about 60 to 90 minutes. Until an internal temperature of about 120 degrees. And then you want to let it rest. So here, let's check out what's going on in the oven. Looks great.
A little rosemary on there.
Yeah. So we have some sprigs that we kind of intertwined.
And you said between 60 and 90 minutes?
60 and 90 minutes.
Basically check it after that first hour, see how it's coming along?
Exactly. No need to baste it or anything.
Gotcha.
Just put it on that grill pan.
Yeah, sure.
Now let me slice a piece for you to taste.
Great. Rosemary really adds flavor, huh?
It does.
Any other type of seasonings you could choose to use to give it any different type of flavor, or is this what you highly recommend?
You know, other flavors like cilantro go great, or, you know, lime juice, lemon juice.
How about something other than like a Dijon mustard? Could you really kind of go off the beaten path with something different?
You could. You could use chili flake. You could use other spices if you like, jalapeno.
May I?
Please.
Okay.
Here, give me some radishes.
Excuse me? Mmm, very nice. Really good.
Delicious, huh?
What have you done with the radishes?
So the radishes we just blanched in boiling salted water and then tossed them with some parsley and olive oil.
That's great. How about the salad? What do we got?
So the salad is a little bit of pesto, which adds a nice richness to a vinaigrette, some shallots and cherry, and a little grape seedle.
Yeah.
A little splash of lemon
juice. Just a little arugula lettuce, right?
And that's it.
Mix it all together.
Exactly.
Nice and easy.
Yeah. Let's move to the
dessert. This is pretty labor, I mean, not too labor intensive. Even just with the lamb, seems pretty easy.
It is. It's really easy.
Just get a good piece of meat.
Exactly. Take your time. Get it nicely tied tight. It's important.
Really good. Cooked to perfection. Is that basically the color you want to see? So, you know, slightly pinkish in there, not too overdone?
Exactly.
It's great.
Medium rare.
Dessert. What were you saying before?
Dessert.
Gubana?
So this dish is called gubana. It's a northern Italian dessert, typical around Easter time, so it's perfect for now.
Mean anything in particular?
You know, it's specially from this little town called Cividale.
Okay.
And it's typically made with like a brioche dough. And here we're going to substitute a croissant if you don't want to do the brioche, but the brioche is on your website. So here we have raisins that are marinated in rum, pine nuts, walnuts, and almonds, and some sugar. And we want to blend these in. You can blend them. No, we're not blending them.
Are we plugged in?
They're blended. They're right here.
Fantastic. What up?
Yep.
There you
Thank
have
you.
It.
So yeah, here, Chris, put some more right here.
Okay.
Now blend those a little more.
There we go.
Beautiful.
This is why I don't cook much. Nothing in my kitchen ever works.
Here.
This is great.
That's great. So here's some cinnamon, some ground cinnamon. So once you have your nuts in your dough, a little ground cinnamon. And here's some butter. And the butter we usually use to glaze it at the end.
Alrighty.
And so we want to take the dough. And remember, this is croissant dough from the store. So you want to make sure that it's the triangulated cuts that they already give you are kind of pressed down so it doesn't come apart.
And this is tough, the old rolling process. Got to be careful, huh?
Yeah, and this is just a little rolling. And roll it up. Keep it nice and snug. Like that.
Yep.
And then we coil it.
And how long will we cook this for when we put it in the pan?
And we'll cook this for about, we'll let it proof a little bit.
Okay.
You know, till it kind of doesn't quite double in size, but about a time and a half. And then we'll cook it for about 45 minutes, 350. And so we'll glaze that with butter, and here we have it right here. Like that.
Fantastic. And so you're saying, how long is it in the oven?
It's in the oven for about 45 minutes.
Final product looks like?
Final product looks like that.
That's incredible. I actually thought there was something else.
Wow, that's
fantastic.
Great.
Kelly, Lonnie, have a locker
right
here.
Yeah, I want to taste that.
Yeah, let's all give it a shot.
I want to taste everything.
No, Kelly, here. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to turn my back to you like that.
I always come for the dessert.
Hey, how do you like Chris's sound effects, by the way?
I think it's pretty good.
We had to improvise there for a second. Yeah, you try it. I want to go back to the lamb for a second because I thought the lamb was fantastic. Really, really good. All right, let's see how you did with the prices here, Lachlan. Mm. We spent a lot of money on the airfare, but man, we still gave you $40 for the budget of the meal. Our first course, take a look, the arugula, the shallots, the lemon, the sherry vinegar, and of course the pesto at $2.99. Our second course, the leg of lamb, that was our high-ticket item, $11.96, but it is a good, good piece of meat, the Dijon mustard, which makes it taste fantastic, $2.19. Rosemary garlic, and for dessert, we're going to continue with the radishes, the mint, the parsley, and our third course. We've got the walnuts, the almonds, pine nuts, raisins, some dark rum, for a grand total of $39.76. He comes in under budget of $40.
Barely, 24 cents to spare.
Yeah, you don't quite get the quarter.
Yeah.
Lachlan, wonderful job. You used to work at the French Laundry, way back in the day. Yeah. Wonderful restaurant. Yeah, thanks so much. If you'd like to get the recipe, go to our website at cbsnews.com. Click on the early show and go to Chef on a Shoestring Recipes. It's right there for your eyes to see. Stay with us. Lachlan Patterson, thank you very much. Coming up, our Second Cup Cafe. It's Five Times August. You're watching the early show right here on CBS. Excuse us as we continue to eat.
Yes, exactly.
I don't know what to do, but I've got a lovely view from here.
This Chef on a Shoestring segment sponsored by Jell-O brand products. Every diet needs a little wiggle room. I'm telling the truth, because I'm a well into you.